Anyway, this is the first slice. I would like to thank the organizer, in particular Alexei and Tatiana, for their invitation and help in this talk online. Okay, I start with to say that this talk could be half an hour, so that I have to cut because it's longer, but it is in review on first master paper published with my former student Armando Consiglio, with the late professor Richard Parish, which died just when we finished a paper, and Alexander Appelblatt. In fact, the references are here. Here you see. But the last paper is with Professor Parish. Okay, I skip the abstract and I would like to say something about my thinking about special function. I know that special function in mathematics is not so considered well because appear boring to physicists and too special to mathematical people. But anyway, I have to say that any application in applied mathematics can be written in terms of special function, like the notes of music, do, re, mi, fa, sol, you can compute, you can compose a song, opera. That the same with a special function. My talk is about right function of second kind because it is my topic. But the merit of this function, in my opinion, is to generalize the Gaussian function, which is so important in many topics of physics and mathematics. Then, so that in second, in section two, I will introduce the right function with particle with the second kind. I have to say that I called the right function because they were introduced by Wright. But on the second kind, I have to say that was considered by Wright in a paper in 1940. I was myself in 94 to consider this independently by Wright because my only source was the chapter on Bachmann project on miscellaneous function where the second index is considered positive, probably for a misprint. So that, anyway, it was original for me to prove to be entire function also when the first parameter is negative. But the problem that for me is important to distinguish the two kinds. And also this is also was pointed out not only in my papers but also with a paper with Gorenflot and Lucco where we recover better this function. In this talk I have an appendix about this function but they are important as I told as I will show in fractional calculus. So that an appendix is made for fractional calculus, but I will delete. In the kind, I would say that I introduce this function, which I called in the literature as M-right function or by Podluni minority function, because in that time, Podluni did not know the contribution by Wright himself. But anyway, the application is due to me because Wright was a pure mathematician and he did not consider the application. The application came out in the fractional calculus. So that fractional calculus, I go back in 94 because before, despite of the fact I considered in my PhD thesis in 66, people laugh, it was not considered yet. So that my paper on 94 was rejected because the referee said, "What is this?" But we have to say that fractional calculus was made by great mathematicians like Liouville, like Abel, first of all, Riemann. So that I did not understand this. Anyway, I have to add also now is the same because now we have an opposite phenomenon. Too many papers. Before, too few papers. Now, too many papers. So that people are against again in many journals, overall in the physical behavior. Anyway, I would like to present my slides. So that I would like to recall what is the right function. You see, it's a generalization of the Bessel function, and it depends on two parameters. One is real, and the other is complex. Usually the first is real, and to be sure to be entire function, explain, lambda should be greater than minus one. And also the series representation could be coupled with the integral representation, where you see already some power law, so that with the Hankel pass, so that you can see some relation with the Quine function of the fractional calculus, the Mittag-Leff function, which is the same without n, but lambda should be positive. This is the main merit of this function of the second kind, because in spite of my efforts and also effort by Lorenzo Luccio, it remains already hidden, this function, in the realm of the special function, in my opinion. Okay, here there is a history about these negative parameters, where I was original in 93 because I was aware only the Button project. I do have the page of the Button where you can see that I was in good page. And in that time, only Button project spoke about this function. I don't know why, but other books ignore completely Mittag-Leff function, except the Russian book in Armenian, by the Armenian. Anyway, it is typical that nowadays we have so many papers on Mittag-Leff function, hundreds of papers. And also we have a book with Lorenzo Luccio and the late Wilbur. So that I prefer to distinguish the first kind and the second kind. And this difference already was also noted by mathematicians like Wong and Zhao, like Luccio, and also Parish, the same. But with Parish, at the end of his life, but I did not know, it was younger than myself, I worked with him because he was a very good specialist on asymptotic expansion, and also was able to plot with Mathematica. And for me, a special function exists only if it is plottable, because in other case it remains to hidden in formulas and not good for application. Physicists, as I am a physicist, of course, I must see what is the function, and also I have to see if the plot match the asymptotic expansion for small and large arguments in the real domain. In any case, just to be polemic, I would like to say that the paper by Paris was rejected by a journal in special function because, according to this journal, plots did not appear. Does not appear because in mathematics plots are left to physicists, to poor people, no? Because in my opinion this is completely wrong because special functions are important for the application. Anyway, Peter-Lefler function is this one. And also the treatise of Gorenflot, we arrived at the second edition. Unfortunately, in the first edition, Kilbas died for the accident in Russia, in Chechnya, but it was his idea to couple the theoretical approach by Kilbas and Rogozin with the application by Gorenflot and Maynard. Then, this was in 2014, and in 2020 we made a second edition, but Gorenflot died before. Okay, in the third edition we will see what is the last editor. Then, to point out the relevance of the right function, I considered two functions only, which I put my name, F and M. This was in 93. But anyway, these are important because one is the green function of the boundary value problem, and this was another boundary value problem. But the M function, which has also a shape of M in some case, when nu is between 1/2 and 1, yes, is the generalization of the Gaussian. So that these functions, of course, are related because the right functions are related by conditions. Then, I would like to say that series expansion, you see, expansion, and then the iterator representation. And you see always the difference between here, there is in the M function, in. But I have to say that this function was already known when the order was 1/2. Because it was 1/2, it is the Gaussian. But for me, because I used the classical calculus, it is a heat equation. So that the first derivative in time, should be rational, and I did not find any conclusion in this respect. For me, it was easy to prove that for one third is a Airy function, and other people, like Niga, found also another relation when it's two thirds with Airy function. But for me, I found with Appelblat that this problem was considered also by other people, but not so well known. Anyway, the difference between the two parts of u, cioè when u is between 0 and 1/2, the real function can be also negative, you see, and so only positive in the positive part. But then, when u is between 1/2 and 1, is always positive. And this fact was important, roughly speaking, to generalize the diffusion and to arrive to the wave equation. Because when u equal 1, the right function reduces to delta function, which it is known is the function, green function of the d'Alembert wave equation. Okay, so that with Paris, and my former student Consiglio, we decide surely the M right function when the The order new is rational could be related to the Whittaker function. But Whittaker function are so called because were introduced by Whittaker by 1903, but nowadays are considered as a special case of more general function, confluent hypergeometric function. But in my opinion, it is better to remain in a particle case, because of course nowadays we have the Fox function, which depends on any parameters. But for a physicist, the parameters should be one, two, three, and no more, because when we have too many parameters, it is difficult. You can fit every problem if you like, as Fermi said, but it's not good. Because in order to understand the phenomena, we need to outline at least three, like space, or four at least, but not more. Okay, and this function, we were able, with the help of Paris, to correct this formula by Stankovic, because Stankovic was the guy. A very good mathematician in Bulgaria, who was the man who told to me that my generalization was already made by Wright, and I was indebted to him. And anyway, Stankovic made, he wrote this expression, which is in our idea is nonsense because the right function, the Whittaker function, is with negative argument and should be not real. Anyway, I have to say this. I call the right function W, yes, and Whittaker function, so that I change in italic W. Nowadays, I discovered that there is another function, like Lambert function, which is denoted by W. So that, you know, is a problem with special function to study a function with the same letters. So that we, based on a paper by Paris, we were able to generalize this function and are here. Here are relations because are the relation made by Paris in terms of the Whittaker function. So you see in the left the right function of the first second kind, and to right the Whittaker function, which are a special case of hypergeometric function. As I say, what is the relevance of this function? Because they are relevant in the time class diffusion wave equation. What is? This is the equation I considered in 1993. It was for me an exercise to go back to the Fresnel calculus, to generalize the simplest differential equation of mathematical physics, using the time derivative in non-integer order between 0 and 2. 0 is excluded, of course, because it's not because it is stationary. Yes, but when beta equal 1, we recover the diffusion equation. Instead, when beta equal 2, we recover the D'Alembert wave equation. So that from physical point of view, this equation is would be considered a generalization to go through diffusion and waves. And for me, it was a great result, even if the referee was a different opinion, of course, because it was considered a mathematical trick, no more. Instead, nowadays, many physicists found the so-called anomalous diffusion. It means not diffusion process which do not obey with the diffusion equation. But anyway, this is also a topic which can be discussed because, but anyway, is out of this topic. But mathematically speaking, what is Poisson derivative? Is an integral differential equation, cioè replacing a differential equation by an integral differential equation where there is a convolution with the first derivative and here with the second derivative. So that we need one condition and here two conditions. And così this is a discontinuity approach to Poisson curves between 0 and 1 and 1 and 2. And for this reason, we prefer to call beta, to divide beta by 2 and call mu, and this mu is a parameter of the right function. Because the right function go second kind, go from 0 and 1 negative. Okay, here are the two problems which I considered. I am a teacher of mathematical physics, so that any people who teach a partial differential equation studied the equation of the wave equation. Usually in books they study only the QC problem which are solved with the Fourier transform, but physicists are also related to the Laplace transform, like an electrical engineer, and consider the signaling problems, which instead is a different problem, which is also very important in seismology, when we have a wave putting an earth, yes, in a shape infinite and book, framework. Yes, and you see, working with Laplace transform, but we can make also with Fourier Laplace transform. Of course, you need to make both Laplace and Fourier. Usually I prefer to use Laplace transform because I came from geophysics, where the Laplace transform is more common than Fourier transform. Yes, but this is a question. I know that mathematicians, they prefer the Fourier transform, but they are related. Yes, and then you see here the Laplace transform. Okay, in the table, I have in 93, this new is only one half, only one half. And for me, it was an exercise of mathematical methods to invert this Laplace transform. And this was my merit, which was an exercise of student, no more, no less. I did not understand why mathematicians did not take care of a parameters different from one half, because one half is related to diffusion. One is related to the Dirac function, but what is the middle? This also was a problem idea, but of course it came from people who are trust in fractional calculus. Fractional calculus is not good to say fractional because the parameters is not integer, is not fractional, but is only for historical reasons. But anyway, just to say that the relation are similar when there is one half. So that my formula are a generalization from one half to nil, no more, no less. The difficulty is that the function is no longer a Gaussian or a Dale. What is this function? It's the right function of the second kind. And here, in terms of M function, is this one. So that when nu is beta, is nu is one half, you can consider is a Gaussian. And here is a different function which is already known in elementary books of mathematical physics. Here we have, I have to finish, but here there is some mathematical results just to compute some moments of this function, because M function can be considered also a probability density function, because generalizing is a Gaussian. But the Gaussian has any moment finite. Instead, is also this function has as different relation with the moment. The moment are not more linear in no more linear in where you don't have nu equal one. Yes, this is important to generalize. I didn't understand why also in other things, the relation between the m right function and the mid left function in the first one is this one, which is not so well known. So that we can relate the in probability theory the Maynard auxiliary function in extremely least equal density. And here are the plots and the plots of this. But I would like to close this topic with looking at YouTube. My student, Armando Consiglio, made simulation of the M-right function where we consider the M-right function symmetric and generalized the Gaussian. And when the parameters go from 0 to 1, of course, cannot go to 1 because the delta function is not potable. So that it goes to 0.85. So that I invite people, I'm not able here to put to go to YouTube, but if you look in YouTube and you look simulation on the right function, you see this phenomenon, okay, where the right function evolve from pure exponential when u equals 0, when u equal 1/2 to Gaussian and u equal 1 to delta function, or to delta function, because the range is between minus infinity to plus infinity. And this, it seems to me, is the best result of this. Ecco, here, these are the photo, yeah? For u between 0 and 1/2, you have this, but in the simulation, we have the simulation in time. You see, here is e minus x modulus, and then it's a question. Then go up this. Ecco, this is the message. The summary of this talk, in my opinion, summary of this talk is these two plots, because you can see for people who are considered the diffusion equation, the wave equation, they consider the green function of the Cauchy problems, where here are the Gaussian and here are the Dirac function. Yes, of course we can consider also the characteristic function, which is the Fourier transform of the grand function, and you see is related to the mid-level function. So that these two functions are very important in functional calculus, so that they become important when functional calculus become important. And in practice, fractional calculus became important after our paper in 93 and also other paper of Bruni by other people, by Messler, and now we have so many journals devoted to fractional calculus, so that many people are against fractional calculus because, but in my opinion, could be considered essentially good because it based to replace ordinary differential equation with integral differential equation. Why the equation should be only differential? To be integral differential. Voltaire said this in that many years ago. So that why don't consider integral equation? When the kernel is power law, you know, this is related to the fractional calculus, and this is the topic of of the appendix. Here I would like to call four sisters. You see, perché in my teach course I use the three sisters because in the Dutch problem, in the Dutch book of Laplace transform was nu equal one half. Here instead we have four because when one minus nu it could be one half or less different than one half. But when nu is one half we have three sisters. I call three sisters because they are here. You say, in fact, in my course, I say the relation between the three sisters in when the back ones were not known, but only the book by Deutsch are, for example, the book by Deutsch is the Bible of the Laplace transform, in my opinion. Yes, and you see, we generalize this in four sisters. Yes, but anyway. Okay. Here are the personal calculus in the appendix, but the time is over, so that I ask to the listener to send me some questions. Like many. I prefer, and also I am able through Tatiana to send to everybody the slides of this, where you can find also the references, and probably you can ask more questions, more useful. Okay, thank you very much for your attention.